Let's talk about regulation as well, because at the moment, there doesn't really seem to be an international code of conduct when it comes to the development of AI. What role can the UAE play in that code of conduct, and would you like to see this being introduced?
So we are playing a big role in trying to start the discussions on where we should regulate artificial intelligence. I'm not for over-regulation, and the UAE is not for regulating a technology for the sake of regulating it. But we are for proactive regulations of certain uses of the technology. Everyone knows that autonomous weapons is a really bad deal for everyone, whether you're in the US, whether you're in the UK, the UAE, or China. Should we do something about it? Yes. So AI should not be used to automate weapons that will kill people on a mass scale. Is there a dialogue that's being had? Maybe, but the UAE is playing a big role in trying to really start these discussions and see where they can lead. There are also certain concerns on how AI is being used. If AI is being used to push people to take certain political decisions or to write against their governments or to do actions that are very negative for everyone everywhere, then we need to continue this discussion and make sure that something is an outcome of it. But should we regulate autonomous driving as a technology? I don't think that this is the right approach. So how autonomous cars will be used should be regulated if they are used in a negative sense. How facial recognition should be used, if it's going to be used in a way that's going to harm people and harm the country in the long term, then we should regulate it. But not regulate it for the sake of regulating it. We need to think of this technology as a technology that builds towards a responsible, positive future. Not something that maybe reaps the benefits or the fruit of the short term, but has many negative impacts in the long term that we cannot overcome.
How do you ensure that the benefits of the fourth industrial revolution spread far and wide and benefit everyone, not just a select few?
It should not be a situation where certain countries and certain individuals move forward and others don't. What the internet has brought to us is because of connecting the billions of people around the world and offering them content and offering them a platform, we were able to advance science, we were able to advance technology, we were able to advance culture as well globally in such a big way. I think that it's important for us to have everyone be a part of the future. If they aren't, there is going to be a global pandemic of tech clash, where countries that are not a part of this are going to revolt against the countries that are a part of this. And I don't think it's in anyone's best interest. If we want to ensure as well that the economic impact of artificial intelligence is seen on a global scale in a positive way, we need to ensure that every country benefits, even if it's 1%. Whether you are an importer or an exporter of this technology, you should know what you're dealing with.
When you look at this, I guess the focus is on job losses when you have automation in place. In particular, here in the UAE, where foreign workers are so important, how is this going to shift the dynamic for the country in the future, do you think, if we have more automation here?
So my job as a minister is to serve the people. My job as a minister is to ensure that this technology is something that benefits the people rather than displaces them. You can jump and hurry into deploying AI in many different fields and ensure that you have economical benefit. But if that leads to societal diminishment of people losing their jobs and being on the streets, that's a bad thing for everyone everywhere. So responsible deployment of AI is very important. My job is, I would say, threefold. First is to ensure that the deployment causes the least amount of displacement and also the highest return for deployment. The return can be seen in two ways. There's economic return and societal return. Everyone wants to have a smart service that's able to cater to their need before they ask for it, that's able to get things done in seconds. And at the same time, everyone wants a better future for themselves. Like, they want to have a job, they want to be able to provide for their families, etc. The second is to upskill everyone and anyone when it comes to jobs that will be lost by AI. So mapping out the jobs that will be lost, try to reduce the number of people that are going into these jobs and the people who are studying, let's say, degrees that are related to these jobs, and ensure that this funnel is limited and upskilling these people.